Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, first we are going to discuss scalar triple product, the products, formed with three vectors, are called triple products. If A, B, C are any three vectors then by inserting dot and the cross between vector A, vector B and vector C in the same alphabetical order we will have the following types of product. First type of product we can have is vector A dot vector B dot vector C, which is meaningless as vector A dot vector B is a scalar quantity and we cannot define dot product between a scalar and a vector quantity. Second, we have vector A dot vector B cross vector C, which is again meaningless since vector A dot vector B is a scalar quantity and we cannot define the cross product between a scalar and a vector quantity. Next we have vector A cross vector B dot vector C, which is meaningful. Since vector A cross vector B is a vector quantity and its dot product with vector C is a scalar quantity and this product is known as scalar triple product. And similarly, vector A cross vector B cross vector C is meaningful and this product is known as vector triple product. Now let us define scalar triple product. Let A, B, C be three vectors. Then the scalar or dot product of one of the vectors and the cross product of the remaining two is called a scalar triple product. Or in other words, we can say that for any three given vectors, vector A cross vector B dot vector C is called the scalar triple product. And is denoted by scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C can also be written as and we know that scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C is equal to vector A cross vector B dot vector C. Now we are going to discuss geometrical interpretation of scalar triple product. Geometrically, the scalar triple product that is vector A cross vector B dot vector C represents the volume of the parallelepiped formed by the three vectors A, B, C at its coterminous edges . Let us draw a parallelepiped whose coterminous edges OP, OQ and OR are represented in magnitude and direction by vector A, vector B and vector C respectively, and vectors A, B, C are three non-coplanar vectors. Now, vector A cross vector B is a vector perpendicular to the plane of vector A and vector B. Here theta is the angle between vector A and vector B. Let theta dash be the angle between vector C and vector A cross vector B. Then vector A cross vector B dot vector C is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into n cap dot vector C. As we know that vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into n cap. Now this can be written as modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into n cap dot vector C, which is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into, now n cap dot vector C can be written as modulus of unit vector n cap into modulus of vector C into cos of theta dash. Therefore, scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C, which is represented by is equal to A into B into sine of theta into modulus of n cap is equal to 1. Now modulus of vector C is equal to C into cos of angle theta dash. Therefore, scalar triple product of vectors ABC is equal to area of parallelogram OPSQ, that is A into B into sine of angle theta into C into cos of theta dash, that is length of perpendicular from C on OPSQ. Which can also be written as scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C is equal to area of the base into height of the parallelepiped Therefore, scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C is equal to volume of the parallelepiped formed by the vectors A, B, C as its coterminous edges. The scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C, which is equal to vector A cross vector B dot vector C, or can also be written as vector A dot vector B cross vector C, is also called the box product. Vector A cross vector B dot vector C is positive or negative accordingly as vector A, vector B, vector C form a right or left handed system. Now we are going to discuss how to express the scalar product vector A cross vector B dot vector C in terms of components. Let vector A be equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap. Vector B be equal to B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap. And vector C be equal to C1 I cap plus C2 J cap plus C3 K cap. Then vector B cross vector C can be written in the determinant form as the determinant containing elements I cap, J cap, K cap, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3, which is equal to I cap into B2 into C3 minus of B3 into C2 minus of J cap into B1 into C3 minus of B3 into C1 plus K cap into B1 into C2 minus of B2 into C1. Now vector A dot vector B cross vector C, where vector A is equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, and vector B cross vector C is equal to I cap into B2 C3 minus B3 C2 minus of J cap into B1 C3 minus B3 C1 plus K cap into B1 C2 minus B2 C1 is equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap dot I cap into B2 C3 minus of B3 C2 minus of J cap into B1 C3 minus of B3 C1 plus K cap into B1 C2 minus of B2 C1. On solving this we get vector A dot vector B cross vector C is equal to A1 into B2 into C3 minus of C2 into B3 minus of A2 into B1 into C3 minus of C1 into B3 plus A3 into B1 into C2 minus of C1 into B2. It can also be written as scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C is equal to the determinant containing elements A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Now we shall discuss condition of coplanarity of three vectors. The necessary and sufficient condition that three non-zero and non-parallel vectors A, B, C be coplanar is scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C is equal to 0. First we shall prove the necessary condition. Let A, B, C be three non-zero, non-parallel and coplanar vectors. And it is to be proved that scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C is equal to 0. In other words, we can say that the volume of the parallelepiped formed by them as coterminous edges is 0. As A, B, C are three non-zero coplanar vectors, therefore, vector B cross vector C is a vector perpendicular to the plane of vector B and vector C. As vector A is coplanar with vector B and vector C, so vector A is also perpendicular to vector B cross vector C. Therefore, vector A dot vector B cross vector C is equal to 0, or we can say scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C is equal to 0. That is, we have dot product of vector A with vector B cross vector C is 0. As for theta is equal to pi by 2, we have vector A dot vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into cos of theta, which is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into cos of pi by 2. Since cos of pi by 2 is equal to 0, therefore we have vector A dot vector B is equal to 0. Now we shall prove the sufficient condition, that is, let scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C be equal to 0, and we have to prove that vector A, vector B and vector C are coplanar. As we have assumed that scalar triple product of vectors A, B, C is equal to 0, which implies that vector A dot vector B cross vector C is equal to 0, and mark this equation as 1. This shows that either vector A is perpendicular to vector B cross vector C, or vector A is equal to 0, or vector B cross vector C is equal to 0, but vector A cannot be equal to 0 as it is given that vector A is a non-zero vector. Now, vector B cross vector C is equal to 0 implies that vector B is equal to 0, vector C is equal to 0, or vector B and vector C are parallel vectors. But it is also given that vector B cannot be equal to 0, vector C cannot be equal to 0, and vector B and vector C are non-parallel vectors. Therefore, vector B cross vector C cannot be equal to 0. Therefore, equation 1 implies that vector A is perpendicular to vector B cross vector C. But vector B cross vector C is perpendicular to the plane of vector B and vector C. Therefore, vector A should be in the plane of vector B and vector C. Therefore, vector A, vector B and vector C are coplanar vectors. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.